What's up? I'm Mike Janella for the New York Mets, and I'm here with one of my favorite Mets, because you remember those 90s teams that I was loving in middle school and high school, Butch Husky. Butch, welcome back to Queens. How you doing?
Thank you. Doing good. Doing good.
Good to see you. Good to have you back. You're here, Mets home opening day, also Jackie Robinson Day, 75th anniversary of Jackie breaking the color barrier in Major League Baseball. You've talked in the past about how much he meant to you. You wore 42, obviously, in your time here with the Mets. Jackie meant a lot of things to a lot of people. What did he mean to you specifically?
It just meant honor, integrity, and, you know, he did a lot of things that I don't know if a lot of people would have been able to do. He went through a lot of things that a lot of people I don't think would have been able to do. And that was the reason I came up and said that I would wear that number, just to have the opportunity to pay his family back a little bit for what he went through, for myself and others to be able to play Major League Baseball.
When did you decide at what point that 42 would be your number?
Well, it was my senior year in high school, and I had to do a term paper. And my teacher knew that I was a baseball player in high school. She suggested that I do it over Jackie Robinson. And from that point on, that was the number I wanted to wear.
Because you were born long after Jackie had already retired. So it wasn't like you grew up watching him. But it was that book report, that teacher that kind of got you into learning about who Jackie was?
That was just deal. It sealed the deal for me.
Man, it's crazy how that happens sometimes. It's such a twist of fate there that ended up, you know, defining a lot of your career moving forward.
Yeah.
What was your favorite thing that you learned, whether it was then or then as you got older, meeting some of his family, becoming a major leaguer yourself? What was your favorite thing about Jackie, the person?
I think it was, like I said earlier, just the integrity he had. You know, we all meet people sometimes that we're not maybe on the same page with, but in order for him to do it, to get spiked and get spat on and, you know, not using the same water fountain as his teammates, not staying in the hotel, man, that takes a lot. And that shows his character. That shows his support system that he had around him with his wife. And that was a big deal to me.
And you got to meet her, right, in 97 with the first Jackie Robinson Day here?
I sure did. It was awesome to be a part of that celebration. And that's when the numbers was retired that night. And I had her sign my jersey. So it's still on the wall.
You still have
that
jersey, right? That's got to be, a memento I'm sure you're never going to forget. What was that conversation like, meeting someone that, you know, her family, her husband, had meant so much to you? You finally get a chance to kind of maybe not pay it back right away, but at least show your appreciation. What was that conversation like?
I don't think I really was able to speak. I was kind of – I couldn't concentrate too well, but – you know, it's just her presence alone there, I mean, it was a tremendous honor.
Jackie is someone that I think, no matter your generation, whether you grew up watching him, you're from your generation, younger players that are in the game today, that's a lasting impact that I think everyone's going to always acknowledge. But being around other players when you came up, or even players that you may talk with now, what do you think Jackie's legacy is to people even nowadays?
It just gives us hope. It gives the younger guys hope. It gave us hope. And I know a lot of guys that I still talk to this day, that was a driving force of them, so maybe they could leave a legacy for some kid to look upon, to have as a goal to try and play Major League Baseball. So it's been a great deal. Major League Baseball's done a great job with it. The Mets have done a great job with it. And we just have to keep it going, keep the ball rolling.
Yeah, we might not truly know what the impact or the effect was on how many people, just because it trickles down to so many people, so many generations. I want to talk about you, Butch, though, because you ended up making the big leagues, big part of these mid-90s Mets, and you come back here, and you're still adored. You know, when we announced you out here at the ballpark earlier, big round of applause from the crowd here at Citi Field. What do you remember most from your time here?
I remember Shea Stadium.
Of course, yeah.
And it's... Sometimes it feels different coming back and not seeing Shea there. You know, when we played there, we didn't like it when we played in it. But now that it's gone, we all miss it. And it was home for me, and I really enjoyed the time. I don't know how you say it. I didn't embrace it the way I should have when I was at Shea Stadium, because now it's gone, it's not there. So that was one of my biggest moments. And being able to perform in front of these fans, I mean, there was nothing better to me.
And a lot of people don't know this, but you almost had a different career path. You got offered to play football at Oklahoma, right? Be a Sooner? And you're from Oklahoma. That's a tough thing to turn down. So what made you end up choosing the baseball route? Because this is always interesting to me.
Yeah, my parents chose it for me. They made me choose it because I wasn't going to sign to play baseball. Jack Zarensic, the scout at the time, stayed at my house for several days trying to get me to sign. And then ultimately my parents won because I think they were going to do some damage to me if I said I wasn't going to play. But I thank God every day and thank the way my parents led me and the decisions that I made to come play baseball.
Not many people can say they got to play in the major leagues, and you're one of the few. So I think that decision ended up working out. One of my favorite memories of you is one I think a lot of Mets fans remember, that Veterans Stadium home run, hitting up to the 600 section. You know how many guys in MLB history made it up there with a dinger?
No, I'd never really heard.
You're one of four ever. That's it. Willie Stargell, Jim Thome, Rene Rivera, and you. Or Ruben Rivera, I should say, and you. What do you remember from that? Because I've watched that on YouTube so many times since it happened that day. But that's some historic power you had.
I just remember the pitcher, Matt Beach. That's pretty much it. And hitting that ball, I never felt it come off the bat. So it made the loud crack. But when you don't feel them, you know they've been hit well. And I didn't really want to do bat flip or anything like that, but I knew it was really gone.
Yeah, and it's got you a place in the trivia question in a record book and with very elite company for sure. And Butch, what have you been up to lately? I mean, a lot of fans, I'm sure, wondering what you've been up to since baseball. What do you got going on these days?
Oh, I spend my time working for a Goodyear tire company. And when I'm not there at the plant or doing something at the plant, I'm helping coach my daughter's softball team. So that's really busy.
What have you learned from when you were a player dealing with your coaches then that now you're the shoes on the other foot? What's your perspective like as a coach now?
Well, girls are different. So coaching those girls, I think they're easier to coach than boys. But the girls want to be more fundamentally sound, so they try harder for you, I think. And, you know, just like any other coach, you try to get your team to buy into what you're doing. And if they buy in, you're going to be successful. But as a father, my daughter tells me I really don't know too much. So
I think that's every daughter with her father, right? No matter what it is. But you do know a lot because you're learning from someone that obviously has that experience at the highest level. Continued best of luck with everything, Butch, and appreciate you swinging by and taking some time to chat with us.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
For all of us here at the Mets and for Butch Husky swinging by here on home opening day and Jackie Robinson Day, we appreciate you guys watching too. And let's go Mets.